Evening, I am Mark Sue with your Lime Sports World. The Barbados cricket captain is having some serious off-field non-cricket issues. Ryan Hines, who also represented the West Indies, was in court today on 7 charges. The charges include assault, criminal damage, reckless driving, dangerous driving, driving without due care and attention, driving without reasonable consideration, and failing to report an accident. The 30-year-old Hainesville St. James resident was released on $2,500 bail with one surety and is scheduled to return to court on December 5th. 3 new world champions were crowned today on the track at the IAAF World Track and Field Championships in Daegu, South Korea. But just like yesterday, another top athlete suffered a major blow. This time it was Cuba's Deron Robles, who was disqualified after winning the men's 110-meter hurdles. CBC's Marsha Boyce has those stories.
The stage was set for the big final of the men's 110-meter hurdles. Among the favorites, Olympic champion and world record holder Deron Robles of Cuba and the former world record holder Liu Zhang of China.
Robles got a cracking start just as he did in the semi-final. Richardson going well. Andy Turner on the inside, but here comes Liu Zhang. Robles is leading just, but Liu Zhang running him down. The Chinese at the... Oh! Robles gets it. Richardson second, Liu Zhang third.
Robles clocking 13.14 seconds, which incidentally is the same time run back in 2009 by Barbadian Ryan Brathwaite for the gold in Berlin. But the celebrations for Robles were cut short. The Chinese delegation lodged a protest against the Cuban. Replays showed that Robles made contact with Liu over the last 2 hurdles, eventually causing him to falter at the final one. Robles was subsequently disqualified, with the USA's Jason Richardson being elevated to the gold medal position, Liu Zhang the silver, and Britain's Andy Turner the bronze. Cuba did appeal, but it was rejected. Meantime, despite a close finish, there was no such drama in the women's 100-meter final, as Carmelita Jeter of the USA became the new world champion in 10.90 seconds.
Fraser Price well away, so to Okugbari, so to Jeter. Fraser Price and Jeter, they're going clear now. Baptiste in third, Campbell Brown's not going to make it. It's Carmelita Jeter.
After 2 bronze medals, she can almost scarce believe it, almost tears in her eyes.
Well, looking at the result, 0.02 of a second separating silver from fourth place. Jeter, certainly the winner, no doubt about that. The American sprinters are back on top of the rostrum.
But you can never rule out Campbell Brown. Wow, she finished like a train.
In the women's 400 meters, the battle for the gold went right down to the wire between Amantle Moncho of Botswana and the USA's Alison Felix.
Away this time. Let's just see who goes hard to the back straight. And it is Alison Felix going off hard. She's already caught up Moncho on her outside. Also going well, Williams Mills, the Jamaican, on the far outside, really powering down that back straight. So it's William Mills at the moment. Moncho is starting to claw her way back to the lead. Alison Felix slightly off the pace as we speak. Moncho is leading in the white vest there of Botswana. She's gone off hard. On her outside, Williams Mills also running hard, but she may fade. Let's wait and see. Alison Felix is coming back. It's Moncho into the front as they hit the last straight. Felix is trying to catch her. Will the strength of Moncho endure this last part of the race? Alison Felix is coming back at her slowly. Moncho is holding on. Felix is coming, but I think Moncho's getting away. Is she? It's close. I think she does get it. Alison Felix in second. And Chapinskaya, I think, gets the bronze medal. What a match down that home straight.
A new national record for Moncho, 49.56 seconds, securing Botswana's first ever medal at a World Championships. Marsha Boyce, CBC Sports.
Controversy brought the curtain down on last evening's second leg of the Seaboard Marine Caribbean Motor Racing Championship, with darkness of the night causing confusion. Before the lighting issues, though, Barbadian Roger Mears had won the first 2 of the 3 event leg at Bushy Park. Race 1 was pretty much your straightforward start-to-finish race. From the flag going into the first turn, Roger Mears in his black Ford Focus picked up the lead, followed by Barry Mears in his yellow Suzuki SX4, Then Mark Vieira of Guyana in the white Mazda RX-8. Fourth was Stuart Williams in the green and grey Lotus Elise. And back in fifth was the event leader coming into Barbados leg, David Somerville of Jamaica in the red Mitsubishi Evolution 8. By the end of the race, Roger Mayers was still out front and he took the checkered flag. Barry, his brother, was still in second spot, but Somerville had passed Vieira and Williams to take third. Here he is powering past the finish line. The second race had more action, much more. Roger Mayers was out front again after the green flag was waved, but behind him, his brother Barry and Stuart Williams were pushing each other, only figuratively at this stage, but heading into the S-Bend, both drivers would lose it, and they would spin off into the safety tires. Williams was faster at getting back into the race, while Barry took too long and couldn't recover to contest a podium spot. Later it would be Mark Maloney in the blue and white Mazda RX-3 and the Guyanese Mark Vieira heading towards the Hammer Bend. You know, these two have a little bit of a history, and Vieira was intent on passing Maloney. The crowd blocked us from seeing what happened next when they connected, but both drivers spun out. Maloney only had to wait for the other drivers to pass before he got back into the race. But Vieira seemed to have some difficulty firing back up. All the while, Roger Mayers was still doing his thing. We're looking for him. There he is, free from contention. And he took the checkered flag for two wins out of two races. This time though, Jamaican Somerville got the second spot. And in spite of the earlier crash, Williams managed to get third. Now, race three was the controversial one. It was dark, and many drivers complained that the event started too late. It actually began after 6 p.m. You could see the taillights better than the machines. You may not be able to tell from this shot, but on the right, trust me, Roger Mayers, who after taking the first two events, just had to slow it right down, and he really wasn't in contention in this one. And here, believing he's the winner, is Mark Maloney. But there was confusion, as some drivers did 8 laps, others did 9. The officials were set to make a ruling on the outcome this evening. Results yesterday, Kenrick Snapper Husbands won all 3 of his races in Group 2. We'll take a break here. When we come back, we'll talk badminton. The badminton championship served off over the weekend in Barbados, with 11 nations taking part, both in team and individual matches, at the Garfield Sobers Gym. CBC's Shane Jones reports on the opening ceremony.
The ceremony got underway with the traditional parade of teams. The 11 participating nations, Brazil, Curacao, Dominican Republic, Jamaica, Guatemala, Guyana, Puerto Rico, Suriname, Trinidad and Tobago, and of course, the hosts. Well, the tournament is here in Barbados, and the Haynesville Youth Group treated the participants to a cultural presentation. After all that, the secretary of Carabaco said the championship is vital for the young players.
Carabaco is really the nursery for our juniors, and we find that, or at least we have found it over the years, because we have not been hosting the championships on a regular basis, when the juniors go to the higher level competitions at the Pan Am level and so on, they don't do as well. So we really need to get the nursery going again so that the under 13s, under 11s, through under 19s can find their feet in international competition.
President of the Barbados Olympic Association, Steve Stelz, said that he is pleased to be part of the venture.
I would like to extend congratulations to the Barbados Badminton Association for its initiative and resolve in resuscitating these championships and also for bringing them to our shores. And I extend a warm welcome from the Barbados Olympic Movement to all competitors and officials, especially those from overseas. I hope you will have an opportunity to enjoy some of the hospitality for which Barbados is famous.
The feature address was delivered by the chairman of the National Sports Council, Siebert Strawn, and he urged every athlete to give of their best.
A tournament like this provides an excellent opportunity for the young people of the region to see top-class international players in action. I am sure that this will help to expand the technical skills of our youth while at the same time promoting a sense of Caribbean unity. The Badminton World Federation has decided to treat this championship as a qualifier for 2012 London Olympics. So I will hope that out of this group that will be playing here for the next couple of days, that I will see you on the television at the Olympic Games next year.
Shane Jones, CBC Sports.
The Barbados senior football team will be hoping to get into Guyana tomorrow morning ahead of their FIFA World Cup qualifier against the hosts on Friday. The Bajans were scheduled to leave the island today, but on arriving at the Grant Lee Adams International Airport, they couldn't leave due to the cancellation of Red Jet flights to Guyana. Manager Franklin Gill told CBC Sports the situation is expected to be rectified by tomorrow, with Red Jet officials promising a charter flight to that country. He's hopeful things will work out to avoid any major disruption to their preparations for the match or any issues with FIFA.
Regulations state quite clearly we ought to be there by Wednesday. But I believe that under these circumstances, we wouldn't like it because we would want to get in order to have a little time to be, to get acclimatized and get ourselves a little practice, etc. But against the background that is current, it's going to be touch and go. But as I said, I'm still very optimistic that we'll be able to go tomorrow morning.
Barbados under-13s have maintained their 100% winning record in the St. Kitts Cricket Festival competition that's currently on. In their latest game, the Bajans crushed Dominica by 6 wickets. After winning the toss and batting, Dominica could only muster 64-9 in their 25 overs. Shamar Springer was the pick of the bowlers, taking 4 for 11. In reply, the Bajans got up to 61 for 4 in 9.4 overs. And Nico Boucher was again the top batsman. He got 20.